Hello students, how are you all? I hope you are all doing very fine. So today we are going to learn chapter 9, that is some applications of trigonometry. Let us see what all points we are going to cover. Small introduction. We will be recalling trigonometric ratios. We will be talking about some applications of trigonometry. Then there are these three terms which are very important for this chapter, that is line of sight, angle of elevation and angle of depression. These three, after we understand these, we will be solving word problems, and these three terms only will help us solve all the word problems of this chapter. Then we will summarize. So let us move on to the next slide. See, till now in trigonometric ratios chapter, that is chapter number 8, you have just studied sine theta, cos theta, tan theta and so on. But in this chapter, we will be talking about how trigonometry is used in real life, because whenever we are studying anything, it is very important to understand why we are actually studying it. So let us recall trigonometric ratios. You know sine theta is equal to what? Perpendicular upon hypotenuse. Cos theta is equal to base upon hypotenuse. Similarly, tan theta is equal to perpendicular upon base. Sine theta is P upon H. And on the basis of these, sine 0 degree 0, sine 30 degree 1 by 2. Similarly, if you talk about cos 60 degree, the value is 1 by 2. So this table, students, please get it printed and paste it on your Almira, because these values are very important. In all the word problems, these values will be used. So let us move on to the next slide. Applications of trigonometry. See, trigonometry has its application in so many fields. See, the world is so big and trigonometry is in itself a very wide subject. But particularly in this chapter, we will be talking about heights and distances. I would like you to see at some pictures that I have added to show you the relevance of trigonometry and real world. See, trigonometry is all about triangles. What kind of triangles? Right angle triangle. Can you see here? I have made a right angle triangle here. This is the 90 degree angle. So this is a tower. And you can figure out that, yeah, there is a triangle. Similarly, this is a machine which is being used in construction. Let's see more pictures. Here you can see a beautiful pyramid. In earlier times, Egyptians also used definitely some kind of mathematics to construct these pyramids. This is a picture of sound waves. The sound waves look like, somewhat look like, the graph of sine theta. I'm not sure, students, whether you know about this or not, but I would definitely ask you to explore it. Just enter applications of trigonometry and find Google images. You will find so many beautiful images which relate mathematics and real world. So these two are up to you. You have to explore these. Let's move on. Now let us understand three crucial terms. Line of sight. What is line of sight? Line drawn from the eye of an observer. To where? To the object viewed. Suppose I am standing here and my eyes are in that direction. Suppose I am looking at an object which is there. So this line which is being formed, it is an imaginary line. This is called line of sight. Clear? So let us move on to the next slide and see. Here you can see this Qutub Minar. Do you know Qutub Minar is in Delhi? Beautiful place to visit. Suppose a person is standing here and the person is looking in this direction. Where is he or she looking? To the top of the Minar. This line being formed is called line of sight. Now other thing to remember is a line which is parallel to the ground from the eyes of the person is called horizontal. So horizontal is parallel to the ground. Now when we move to the previous slide, second term we can easily understand, angle of elevation. See, elevation means raising the level. Suppose See, in this next slide, the person has to raise the head to look at the top of the minar. That means this angle being formed between the line of sight and horizontal is called angle of elevation. Do you understand? So, moving to the next slide. Angle of depression we will understand. Let's move on to the next slide. See, suppose a person is standing here and the person is looking at a building. So, this line of sight and this is horizontal. This angle is angle of elevation. But suppose a person is at the terrace of the building and the person is looking at the ground, then we get angle of depression. That means we have to lower our head. So, where will the angle be formed? Between the horizontal and the line of sight. See, so this is the angle of elevation and this is the angle of depression. So, when we have to raise our head, the angle of elevation. When we have to lower our head, angle of depression. See, this girl is standing at the roof and looking downwards at this object. This is the horizontal level and this is the line of sight. So, this is the angle of depression. If the person would have looked upwards, then angle of elevation would have been formed. Okay? Now, let's move on to examples. So, this is example 1 from your NCERT book. A very simple example. What it says, a tower stands vertically on the ground. Okay? We have made a tower on the ground. Now, what? From a point on the ground. So, there is a point on the ground. I don't know where, which is 15 meters away. So, now I know this is a point which is 15 meters away from the foot of the tower. Now, the angle of elevation of the top of the tower. Okay, one thing I want you to know, when it says angle of elevation of the top, then it means when you are going towards the top, the angle formed at the beginning point, remember. So, angle of elevation of the top of the tower is found to be 60 degrees. So, this is 60 degrees. Okay, what we have to find? We have to find the height of the tower. We have to find the height of the tower. So, just see this figure. This is the tower. 15 meter is this distance. This angle is 60 degrees and we just have to find AB. So, what is AB? And how we are going to find it? So, we have to focus on the triangle that can be seen here. We know that this is one angle, this is one side. We have to find the other side. So, we will apply what? Trigonometry, definitely, because trigonometric ratios tell us the relation between side lengths and angles. Okay? Here AB represents the tower. CB is the distance of the point from the top and angle ACB is the angle of elevation. See, angle ACB. This is 60 degree. We have to find height of the tower, that is AB. So, in this triangle, this angle and these two sides, how will they be related? This is perpendicular, this is base and this is one angle. So, we will first of all write the name of the triangle, that is triangle ABC. See, in this triangle ABC, AB upon BC will be equal to what? Tan 60, because we have just recalled that tan is perpendicular upon base. So, AB, which is the height of the tower, will be equal to tan 60, which is under root 3 into BC, which is 15. So, 15 root 3 is AB, which means The height of the tower is 15 root 3 meters. Okay? So, let us look at the next example. That is example 6 from your NCERT book. Angles of depression. Now, it doesn't talk about angle of elevation. It talks about angle of depression. That means we have to go below the horizontal level. Let us read the question. Angles of depression of the top and bottom of an 8 meter tall building. So, first of all, I am making this 8 meter tall building on the ground. Now, from a top of multi-storied building, where the angles are coming, what is the starting point? Starting point is the top of multi-storied building. Now, this is my multi-storied building, and from the top of this building, angles of depression are being made to the top and bottom of the 8 meter tall building. Now, obviously, when it talks about angle of depression, that means you are going below. You are lowering the level. So, this multi-storied building has to be taller than this 8 meter tall building, right? When we understand how to put the question into the figure, it becomes much easier. Now, we have to find the height of the multi-storied building and also the distance between these two buildings. So, what we have to find? Height of this building and distance between these two. Let us look at the proper figure. So, this is the figure given in your NCERT book. PC is what? Multi-storied building. Can you see? AB is 8 meter tall building. Now, 30 degree and 45 degree are the angles. So, this angle, this is the top of the what? Top of the 8 meter tall building. So, this angle of depression is 30 degree and this angle. Angle of depression from the top of the multi-storied building to the bottom of the 8 meter tall building is 45 degree. So, this is 45 and this is 30, right? Sometimes this word respectively will not be written. You have to figure out yourself which angle is bigger, which angle is smaller. You have to understand by yourself, right? We have to find the height of the, right? We have to find PC. I will just write what we have to find. We have to find the value of PC and also AC, which is the distance between foot of these two buildings, okay? So, let us look at the solution. Observe that PB is transversal to the parallel lines PQ and BD. PQ and BD, these are what? Parallel lines, right? And this PB is transversal. So, here you can see that with this red colored pen, I have made a Z-like figure, which means that this and this, this pair forms alternate interior angles. So, this angle QPB, QPB will be equal to angle PBD, PBD. These two angles will be equal. So, that means we have found angle PBD equal to 30 degree. Similarly, angle PAC will be 45. I will tell you how. Angle PAC. See, this QPAC, this forms a Z-like figure again. So, this angle, this bigger angle is 45. Therefore, this angle PAC will also be 45 degrees. So, we have found two angles by using what? Alternate interior angles. So, now see, in triangle PBD, here we have two triangles, two right angle triangles. PBD, PBD. So, in this triangle, this is the 90 degree, right? We have this angle 30 degree. So, if you apply perpendicular upon base equal to tan theta, you can see that PD upon BD equal to tan 30 degree. PD upon BD equal to 1 by root 3, which means that BD will be equal to root 3 into PD. Now, in triangle PAC, PAC, this right angle triangle, you can see again if you try to apply tan theta, you get PC upon AC, perpendicular upon base, equal to what? Tan of this angle, which is 45 degree. So you will write PC upon AC equal to tan 45, which is 1. Therefore, PC equal to AC, okay? Now, let us move on to the next slide. Now, PC is equal to PD plus DC. See, PC is the sum of these two lengths, PD and DC. Also, PC is equal to AC, we have just found. So, we have replaced PC with AC, which gets us PD plus DC equal to 8. One more thing, here AB and CD are equal. Clearly, these two lengths are equal and the value of this length is 8 meter because it is given in the question that this building is 8 meter tall. So, if we write this equation again, we will write PD plus DC, which is equal to AB. So, I am putting the value 8 equal to AC, okay? Also, AC is equal to BD. So, I can write AC also. I can write BD also. But I am writing here BD. Why? Because we just found that BD and PD are related. BD is equal to root 3 into PD. So, we write this equation again. We get PD plus 8 equal to under root 3 PD. Okay. So, you can easily solve this equation and you will get what? You will get PD is equal to 8 upon under root 3 minus 1 meters. How? You can bring this PD to the right hand side. You can take PD common, you will get root 3 minus 1, and by cross multiplication, or you say that bringing root 3 minus 1 to the denominator, you get the value of PD. Now you know that PC is the sum of PD and DC, okay? So, PC is equal to PD, which is 8 upon root 3 minus 1, and what? This value, which is 8. So, you can solve this, you can rationalize this and add these to get the solution. So, rest, the last step is homework for you, okay? So, moving on to next slide, this question. So, I am giving you hint for this question. It is very interesting. A tree breaks due to storm. Now, you would be thinking, what is the use of tree in this question? I will tell you, a tree breaks due to storm and the broken part bends. So, I would like you to see the figure. See, this tree was upright, but due to storm, it broke at this point and it bent down like that. And it made a triangle, okay? So, this is the simpler figure. This is the broken tree problem where the broken tree forms a triangle with the ground, okay? So, we are given two things, that the ground making an angle 30 degree. See, this angle we are given, the distance between foot of the tree to the point where the top touches the ground, which means the distance between these two points is 8. So, looking at the figure, suppose this is the ground. This was the tree which was upright earlier. Then due to storm, it broke down here. This part fell on the ground, which means that this length is obviously equal to this length. Okay. Now, they are saying that, let us read the question quickly. A tree breaks due to storm and the broken part bends so that the top of the tree touches the ground making an angle 30 degree, which means this is 30 degree. Next thing, the distance between the foot of the tree, this is the foot of the tree, where the top touches the ground, this point. So, this distance is given 8. Now, this question looked a little complex, but this figure is so simple. Just a simple right angle triangle. One side is given, one angle is given. We have to find the height of the tree, which means we have to find this and this. Then we add these two and we get the whole length, which means we get the length of the tree. Now, for finding this, you can simply apply, this is what? Perpendicular. This is hypotenuse and this is 8 equal to base. So, if you apply perpendicular upon base equal to tan 30, you can get the value of P. And if you apply cos theta, which means 8 upon HY, base upon hypotenuse, you get the value of hypotenuse. Now, P plus this value will give you the length of the tree, and this value is equal to H. So, I think I have given you enough hint and you can simply do this question. So, moving on. Now, let me give you some questions for assignment. This question number 6 from exercise 9.1 of your NCERT. A 1.5 meter tall boy is standing at some distance from a 30 meter tall building. See, this is the 30 meter tall building. The angle of elevation from his eyes to the top of the building increases from 30 degree to 60 degree as he walks towards the building. So suppose the boy was here initially. At this point, the angle of elevation was 30 degree. This. Now the person started walking in this direction, and when the boy reached at this point, suppose this is the boy, here the angle of elevation changed from 30 to 60. The angle is becoming larger. What we have to find is distance he walked towards the building, which means we have to find the value of DE, or you can label this point as M, you can call it CM, you will have to find CM. So, you can take these two triangles AEF and ADF and apply tan 30 degree, tan 60 degree, you can find the values. And this is assignment, so you have to do the rest part. Let us move on to next question. Two poles of equal heights are standing opposite each other on either side of the road, which is 80 meter wide. So, let's look at the figure. This is the road CB, which is 80 meters wide, and two poles are standing, the pole DC and the pole AB. They are of equal heights. It is given to you. From a point between them, it is not given that the point will be midpoint or exact position is not given, but on this BC, the point is somewhere, let's call it E. So, this point, the angles of elevations of the top of the poles are given 30 degree and 60 degree. So, here you can see these two triangles, right? We have to find the height of the poles. We have to find DC or AB. These two are equal. So, you just have to find one value. These two are equal. Also, we have to find the distances of the point from the poles, which means we have to find the distance of this point from C and distance of this point from B, which means we have to find CE and also BE. So, it is a very simple question. We have two right angle triangles. First, triangle DCE and second, triangle ABE, right? In these two triangles, you just have to apply trigonometric ratio and you will get two equations involving two variables, H and X, and you can solve them to get the answer. So this is assignment, so rest part is on you. So let us just summarize. We studied line of sight. The line of sight is the line drawn from the eye of an observer to the point in the object viewed by the observer, right? Angle of elevation. What is angle of elevation? Angle formed by the line of sight with the horizontal when it is above the horizontal level. Third, angle of depression. The angle formed by the line of sight with the horizontal when it is below the horizontal level is angle of depression. Then, height or length of an object or distance between two distant objects can be determined with the help of trigonometric ratios. I hope now you have understood all the applications of trigonometry and whatever I told you in this session. Thank you.